Hello, good people of the internet. As you might have heard, Nikon is currently not just in hot water, but in water that is slowly but surely reaching its boiling point. Despite releasing two well-received mirrorless cameras in the past year, the general decline of their camera sales was only compounded by the ongoing pandemic. Many have compared this situation with another company's failure. Not too long ago, we saw a once mighty camera brand in Olympus falter. While their imaging division wasn't dissolved but sold off to Japan Industrial Partners, it's fair to say that the Olympus we once knew is no more. Will the same happen to Nikon? Will they even be able to survive? And how the heck did they end up in this sticky situation? That's what we'll be discussing in this video. Nikon had an absolutely brutal 2020, with its revenue dropping by over $1 billion since 2018. To properly analyze the situation, we need to know what these so-called camera companies actually do, because the camera companies we know and love aren't actually camera companies. All except for Nikon. We all know that Sony isn't just in the camera business. It does TVs, PlayStations, phones, and just about everything else you can think of. Surprisingly, its main source of revenue actually comes from selling life insurances. Who'd have thought that? Canon produces a variety of office and industrial products, which bring in more money than its imaging division. Its portfolio includes printers, scanners, projectors, and even calculators. Fujifilm's bread and butter are document solutions and its healthcare division, which got a nice boost during the pandemic. Its camera division is the smallest division in terms of revenue. By the way, if you're a fan of Fujifilm cameras, make sure to subscribe to my channel. I've got a bunch of videos on my X-T4 coming up in the near future. Don't miss out on those. Right, back to the content. But even Nikon doesn't just produce cameras, just like many other manufacturers. Their imaging division is one of many. But compared to most other big brands, Nikon's imaging division was historically its main business and top earner. Thus, you could genuinely claim that Nikon was the only true camera company. But with the camera industry shrinking in general, that was always going to be an issue. In the past year, Nikon's imaging division wasn't their top earner, possibly for the first time in modern history. I couldn't find enough data to verify this, but it definitely was the first time in many years. That is a big problem. It was surpassed by the precision equipment business for sales and profit. Not only that, but the imaging division accounted for the bulk of losses, and Nikon is now anticipating a historic $720 million loss, which would be its worst scale financial loss ever. Representatives at Nikon have already speculated that their slump stems from their slow transition to mirrorless. The Nikon Z system was introduced in late 2018, long after Sony was dominating the full-frame mirrorless market. Perhaps they should have bought Samsung's NX technology after all. In addition, the delays in production and the postponed Tokyo Olympics caused by COVID-19 certainly didn't help out either. Despite that, they're apparently hoping that mirrorless cameras which use their Z mount are what will bring them out of this situation and revive them. And despite the current doom and gloom hovering around Nikon, the Z7 II is actually selling really well in Japan and was only outsold by the EOS R5 in December. They've already laid off 700 workers in Thailand and Laos, and the plan is to cut more than 2,000 further overseas jobs and to fully move the production of camera bodies out of Japan to Thailand. We can also expect to be seeing fewer cameras from Nikon in the coming years, but don't worry, the main reduction will be in the low-end market. They have already killed off the Nikon One system, and more cameras are likely to follow. They will instead focus more on their Z mount, so expect to see many more lenses and a greater range of bodies in the near future. It is also possible that Nikon will be pulling out of less profitable markets as they did in 2018 when they stopped selling cameras in Brazil. But what if Nikon can't turn it around? What if they fail and end up in the same situation as Olympus did? One possibility is that other Japanese camera manufacturers such as Canon, Sony, and Panasonic will bail them out. It's not as outlandish as it might sound. At one point in 2012, Sony invested $650 million in Olympus to keep the company going. You see, Japanese businesses operate differently to their Western equivalents. Sony's thought behind that investment was that if Olympus were to fail, the entire market segment's viability might be brought into question. When a big player such as Olympus fails, it makes the entire industry look unstable, which is why each competitor wants a blossoming imaging industry and definitely not a failing one. Were Nikon, once such a mighty camera company, to fail, it would be a huge blow to the camera industry as a whole. I can guarantee that headlines like "Smartphones kill Nikon" and "Why buy a mirrorless camera when you've got an iPhone?" would be popping up left, right and center. Their second option is again something we don't have an equivalent to in the West. While still being an independent company with out a parent company, Nikon is part of the Mitsubishi Keiretsu. A horizontal Keiretsu such as Mitsubishi's is set up around a Japanese bank through cross-shareholding relationships with other companies. So the bank owns pieces of the companies while they hold pieces of it. In this case, the bank would be the Bank of Tokyo Mitsubishi. A horizontal keiretsu consists of companies that have little to nothing to do with each other. Nikon's leadership will work with the leadership of multiple businesses, and together they determine the investment strategy and distribution. It's not guaranteed that the Mitsubishi keiretsu would invest in Nikon to keep them afloat, but due to the interaction between the individual members, we can assume that Nikon is at least well connected and has access to many great minds. Don't forget that Nikon is still a huge brand name. While Olympus had faded into obscurity, especially in Western countries, Nikon is still pretty much a household name around the globe. We all remember the Nikon versus Canon debate, and such a strong brand name should give them some extra protection. What also differs them from Olympus is that Nikon already have the technology to potentially succeed on hand. Olympus had nothing comparable to the Z-mount and was still banking on Micro Four Thirds. Nikon has already released multiple well-received and competitively priced full-frame mirrorless cameras and already has a decent lineup of lenses. To sum it up, Nikon could definitely fail, but it's possible that other camera manufacturers would bail them out. They are well connected and, despite the numbers, are potentially in a better place than Olympus ever was. Cost-cutting measures mean jobs will be lost and production will move away from Japan. Finally, the success of the Z-mount is absolutely crucial to the survival of Nikon. I do hope this video has helped you understand the story behind all the recent headlines you've been reading. If you did learn anything or just watched for pure enjoyment, please do hit that like button to show your appreciation and consider subscribing to the channel. And if you didn't like this video, make sure you hit the dislike button twice to make it extra impactful. And with that, it has been just about enough from me for one day. If you can't get enough of me, come and hang out in the comments or follow me on Twitter. Bye.